Vermont CDL tanker vehicles test.
Question 1. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
speed up slightly. Downshift twice. Brake lightly.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 2. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
water content, air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 3. Empty trucks.
Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 4. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 5. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
driving against the wind, going uphill or downhill, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 6. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
barriers, bulkheads, baffles.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 7. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 8. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 9. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Side to side, front to back, top to bottom.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 10. Side to side surge can cause
overspeeding, a rollover, suspension system failure.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 11. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expend in transit, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 12. Altage means
how fast the liquid tanks drain. Allowance for expansion of liquid. Liquid weight.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 13. Liquid-tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
barriers, baffles, bulkheads.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 14. Separators with openings or holes in them that are between compartments in a tank are called
baffles, bulkheads, barriers.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 15. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. Use only the emergency brakes.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 16. Empty trucks
may require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 17. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Uneven expansion. Liquid movement. Extreme weight.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 18. Side-to-side surge can cause
a rollover, suspension system failure, overspeeding.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 19. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
The truck will roll over. You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 20. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
starting or stopping, going uphill or downhill, driving against the wind.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 21. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
liquid movement. Both of these answers are correct. High center of gravity.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 22. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called?
Bulkheads. Baffles. Barriers.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 23. Outage means.
Allowance for expansion of liquid. How fast the liquid tanks drain. Liquid weight.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 24. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
Use only the emergency brakes. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 25. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on.
The legal weight limits. The amount the liquid will expand in transit. Both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 26. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 27. Empty trucks.
Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 28. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are.
Driving against the wind. Going uphill or downhill. Starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 29. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are.
Loading and unloading. Starting or stopping. Hauling milk or other food products.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 30. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 31. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
air to fuel ratio, water content, distribution of weight.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 32. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use controlled door stab braking. Lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes.
Answer.
Use controlled door stab braking.
Question 33. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
barriers, baffles, bulkheads.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 34. Separators with openings or holes in them that are between compartments in a tank are called
barriers, baffles, bulkheads.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 35. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
speed up slightly, downshift twice, brake lightly.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 36. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 37. Empty trucks
stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 38. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Both of these answers are correct. Liquid movement. High center of gravity.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 39. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
barriers, bulkheads, baffles.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 40. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Front to back, side to side, top to bottom.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 41. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill. Driving against the wind. Starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 42. Side-to-side surge can cause.
A rollover. Suspension system failure. Overspeeding.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 43. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom. Front to back. Side to side.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 44. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Never. Only if the tank has baffles. Always.
Answer.
Always.
Question 45. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Extreme weight. Uneven expansion. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 46. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge lets you turn corners tighter. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 47. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called.
Baffles. Barriers. Bulkheads.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 48. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 49. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
Use only the emergency brakes. A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 50. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called.
Barriers. Baffles. Bulkheads.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 51. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called.
Bulkheads. Baffles. Barriers.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 52. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Only if the tank has baffles. Always. Never.
Answer.
Always.
Question 53. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
distribution of weight, water content, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 54. Empty trucks
have better traction when stopping than full trucks. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 55. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Both of these answers are correct. High center of gravity. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 56. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 57. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge lets you turn corners tighter. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 58. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom. Side to side. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 59. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Uneven expansion. Extreme weight. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 60. Altage means
how fast the liquid tanks drain. Liquid weight. Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 61. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
water content, distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 62. Empty trucks
have better traction when stopping than full trucks. may require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 63. Side-to-side surge can cause
overspeeding, suspension system failure, a rollover.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 64. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expand in transit, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 65. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 66. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
Use only the emergency brakes. A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 67. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles. There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 68. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds. The distance you can see ahead. The length of your vehicle.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 69. Side-to-side surge can cause
a rollover, suspension system failure, overspeeding.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 70. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expand in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 71. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will seem heavier than it really is. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 72. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly. Speed up slightly. Downshift twice.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 73. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes. Use controlled doorstop braking.
Answer.
Use controlled doorstop braking.
Question 74. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom. Front to back. Side to side.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 75. Empty trucks.
Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 76. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Side to side. Front to back. Top to bottom.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 77. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
starting or stopping, loading and unloading, hauling milk or other food products.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 78. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expend in transit, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 79. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles. The truck will seem heavier than it really is.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 80. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 81. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 82. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly. Speed up slightly. Downshift twice.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 83. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Liquid movement. Both of these answers are correct. High center of gravity.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 84. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Extreme weight. Liquid movement. Uneven expansion.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 85. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expand in transit. Both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 86. Empty trucks
have better traction when stopping than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 87. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Top to bottom. Front to back. Side to side.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 88. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom. Side to side. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 89. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles. The truck will seem heavier than it really is. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 90. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 91. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
downshift twice, speed up slightly, brake lightly.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 92. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
distribution of weight, water content, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 93. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
driving against the wind, going uphill or downhill, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 94. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expend in transit, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 95. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 96. Outage means
how fast the liquid tanks drain, liquid weight, allowance for expansion of liquid.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 97. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Liquid movement. Extreme weight. Uneven expansion.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 98. Liquid-tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
bulkheads, barriers, baffles.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 99. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
distribution of weight, water content, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 100. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge lets you turn corners tighter. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 101. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
high center of gravity. Both of these answers are correct. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 102. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 103. Liquid-tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
bulkheads, baffles, barriers.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 104. Empty trucks
may require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 105. Side-to-side surge can cause
suspension system failure, overspeeding, a rollover.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 106. Separators with openings or holes in them that are between compartments in a tank are called
barriers, bulkheads, baffles.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 107. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 108. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom. Front to back. Side to side.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 109. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill, driving against the wind, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 110. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 111. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. Use only the emergency brakes. A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 112. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expend in transit, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 113. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 114. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
starting or stopping, hauling milk or other food products, loading and unloading.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 115. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called
bulkheads, baffles, barriers.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 116. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes. Use control doorstep braking.
Answer.
Use control doorstep braking.
Question 117. Empty trucks
have better traction when stopping than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 118. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
hauling milk or other food products, starting or stopping, loading and unloading.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 119. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
Use only the emergency brakes. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 120. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 121. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge lets you turn corners tighter. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 122. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
The truck will roll over. You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 123. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will seem heavier than it really is. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 124. Altage means?
Liquid weight. How fast the liquid tanks drain. Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 125. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use only the emergency brakes. Lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use controlled door stab braking.
Answer.
Use controlled door stab braking.
Question 126. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Some liquids expand more than others when they get warm. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expand more than others when they get warm.
Question 127. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 128. Side-to-side surge can cause
suspension system failure, overspeeding, a rollover.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 129. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
Going uphill or downhill. Driving against the wind. Starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 130. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called?
Bulkheads. Baffles. Barriers.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 131. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 132. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
hauling milk or other food products, loading and unloading, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 133. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Never. Always. Only if the tank has baffles.
Answer.
Always. Thank you for watching the video and wish you will get your driver license soon.